fire popping kind of crackle. We were heating up the pork and beans. Bubba said, man, it don't get any better than this, if you know what I mean. We sat there for a minute listening to the crickets, thinking this was pretty hard to beat. Till Junior stood up, spit in the fire, and said, boys, I hate to disagree, but if a busload of women, really good-looking women, just suddenly pulled in here, and old Joe T. Garcia showed up with fajitas and a 100-gallon keg of beer, and had to drop by and brought Willie with them, and they started taking requests. Well, don't get me wrong, boys, this is pretty good, but it could get
Tuesday, day four of our journey. After an excellent campsite last night, 10k out of town, up on the hill, beautiful campsite. Coming to White Cliffs this morning. A couple of us were a bit seedy. Billy had a bit too much to drink, a bit too much Jim Beam. I could share some stories about it, but it didn't end well for the poor old man. I hit the rum, so I feel a bit seedy and come into town, and the boys are a bit upset because the coffee machine's broken. They need their coffee in the mornings, they can't have any. Boo-hoo. I'm not a coffee drinker, so I'm fine. But anyway, I thought I'd just do a quick little walk around this little area here, so I've got some footage of my time in White Cliffs. This is a really good national park visitor centre there. So the Puruu Darling National Park is split into two. And we, yesterday on our way out to towards Will Kenya, we called into the southern bit, checked out an awesome campsite there, but we're not going to check out this bit, the northern bit today. We're on our way to Tibooburra today. And this whole shire out here is just, every town's got these things in them. It's quite interesting. Get your history in that off it. Now we're basically at the main street, you might call it, the main street of White Cliffs. You've got the pub over there and you've got the general store, and then
dancing Hank Parker floated by in a boat and volunteered to be our fishing guides, and Richard Petty pulled up in the old 43 car and asked us if we wanted a ride. We'd all sit around singing Poncho and Lefty playing poker, smoking big cigars. Now don't take offense, y'all.
Underground. Hey Billy, we're underground, mate. At the underground hotel.
Excellent.
I don't like it.
We content just sitting here under the stars. But if a busload of women, really good looking women, just suddenly pulled in here, old Emerald Lagasse showed up with Kibasi and a 100-gallon keg of beer. I had to drop by and talk Willie with them. They started taking requests. And don't get me wrong, boys, this is pretty good, but it could get better than this.
You don't go to White Cliffs without checking out what White Cliffs is famous for, that is the opals. So we chose a opal mine, a local opal mine called Southern Cross Opals, and we cruised up there and checked it out. Old mate who runs the place, brilliant fellow, loves to tell a story. He can yarn all day, you talk about history, talks about his mines, he's happy to share information with you, which is really good. I purchased a couple of small opals on keyrings for my daughters, which they absolutely loved. I'm surprised, not being a jewelry person, I was actually blown away by how beautiful opals were. With our morning complete at Whitecliffs, it was time to push on. We decided to go to Packsaddle, and then from Packsaddle we'd head north up towards Tibooburra.
It's a plume of dust down an old dirt road, hanging off the rails at the rodeo. A back veranda with creaking boards, and the dark rage of a thunderstorm. Stockman's bar and an old bush pub, and chasing Mickey's through the scrub. It's planting seed and praying for rain, and red dust running through your veins. It's just the way it is, it's the way it goes. When my wheels hit the gravel road and it feels like home, the way of life, it's the life I live, and I'm right where I wanna be. It's the way it is. It's a corrugated iron shed, work boots on the back doorstep, scones in the oven and preserves in jars, talking prices at the sale yards.
Think myself, we're somewhere between Whitecliffs and Packsaddle, and the landscape out here is just phenomenal. Absolutely love it. There's the two Toyotas over my shoulder over there. If you swing around here, we got Billy's D-Max. Pretty desolate country. I don't know what that mountain is way up there, but it looks pretty cool. We're sort of heading towards it, so I hope we can check that out. I think it might be part of a national park. Yeah. It's a good little road, this one. Exciting. Big dips, washouts, the whole lot. You got these two gronks over here, look at them. We're having a good time, aren't we, boys?
Yeah. On a time schedule.
No, I'm just seeing if it's any good. Fuck, it's green though, Jesus. A little bit of a puddle of water. Yeah, we're going to stop here at this creek because it looks pretty cool. I just want to have a look at it. Here we are, we stopped at this creek. See, they've had rain fairly recently, don't know how long ago, can't remember. But look how green it is, beautiful and green. And a lot of stuff come down here, down this creek bed. Very thick, but soft. Sink in it. It's interesting, isn't it? What are you looking at over there, Chris? Chris is all excited. He thinks he's been to Whitecliffs. He thinks he's an opal miner now. All the different layers of the soil there. There's a big channel that's down here.
Red dirt, make a rainbow
beach. Oh, yeah! So, we're still at this same creek, but Chris has decided to go and get his metal detector out. There he is, his metal detector, and having no luck. That is cool. I'll stop and have a look, get a video of that. That is cool. Just out along this road to Packsaddle, just come along this really cool little rock formation out in the middle of nowhere. It's natural. Been here for a long time. But it's pretty darn cool, I must admit.
Long straight roads and one horse towns, sheepdogs bringing the mob around. She'll be right. Go, it's good on you, mate. And what do you know? It's just the way it is, it's the way it goes. When my wheels hit the gravel road and it feels like home, it's a way of life. Rusty tank with flaking paint, and a weary digger on Anzac Day. Dreamtime land in Uluru, it's Aborigine.
Literally is just a, as they say, it's a dot on the road map, isn't it? It's a pretty cool little house, somewhere between Packsaddle and Milperinka. I've come as far west of us as I've ever driven in the state before. Well, that's not true. I have been down through Hay and that across to Adelaide, but I'm talking in the real New South Wales outback. So this is as outback as I'm going to get. There's not much here. It is just an empty, empty landscape. Which will come as no surprise to most people. But it's the first time I've ever seen it, so it's intriguing me. And I find it interesting nonetheless. Although, keeping an eye out to try and find some wildlife, but there's nothing. I haven't seen any snakes, any lizards. I saw a wedge-tailed eagle earlier, that was pretty cool. A couple of skippies.
Didgeridoo, banded hats, calloused hands, the spirit of.
Made it to Tibooburra. There's the boys. Tibooburra.
Talk about Texas and how big it is, and rolling down that big old Mississippi. They got a canyon they think is really grand. We got a rock that would fill the whole damn thing. Fancy pickup trucks with your shotgun racks. We got utes and rhubarbs, swags in the back. They got them light beers, 100 different brands. They need to harden up and put a bunny in their hand. Midnight campfire.
We decided to camp for the night in the Aboriginal Council grounds, which is a lovely little campsite. Any money raised from there went to the local Aboriginal community, so that was good, but it was a really good campsite. Showers, toilets, plenty of space, just far enough out of town to not hear any noise. Perfect. So after getting to camp, halfway through setting up, we look across the creek crossing, and here's this old duck in a Toyota Camry, got herself bogged in the creek. She shouldn't have been taking the car across there. Anyway, she was probably, I'd say, maybe mid-50s to early 60s, out on her own, travelling around the country, so good on her. Being the nice chaps we are, we went across and tried to get her out and couldn't, so I had a chance to try my winch, which had been installed the previous week. Got it out and just gave the camera a bit of a nudge, pulled it up, and bobbed your apple, so to speak. She was out, and the world was a happy place. We could continue our night.
Trouble and strife, how's it hanging? A little to the right. Feed the chooks, had a shocker. Up the creek and he's off his rocker. In like Flynn, how's his lies? That's not a knife. Midnight camp.